Hey guys, it's your boy Crippers, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Liverpool Chroma, where last time I left off. He defeated Manchester United in the league, and I completed the first leg of my first knockout round of the Champions League match against Anderlecht. Yes. In this episode, as you can see, first up is the Capital One Cup final against West Bromwich Albion at Wembley Stadium. I'm a bit flustered because I'm angry. I'm not gonna lie. For the first time since he got to Liverpool, Jurgen Klopp has made a bad decision, and the bad decision that he's made is, for some reason, I don't know why, but we are apparently going to sell Jordan Ibe. And I was racking my brain. I'm still trying to figure it out. Why? Why sell another of your best players? I mean, last season we sold that piece of shit because he didn't want to stay at Liverpool. But I've not heard Jordan Ibe complain once about wanting to leave Liverpool. So why? Especially for such a low fee, because he could build Ibe into an amazing player and get a good fee for him. But 15 million? And, I mean, yes, he's going to get a lot more game time at Bournemouth, but loan him! Freaking loan him! I mean, I'm pointing out the obvious solution to the problem here. Don't take the 15 million now. Loan Ibe to Bournemouth. He gets games. He gets slowly better. And in time, he's worth double 15 million. Nor 16 million. Or wherever the fuck they accepted. I can't figure it out. It doesn't make any sense. I mean, and now Brunt. Unless Liverpool are planning to sign an amazing young talent that no one's ever heard of, they pull practically the next Lionel Messi off the street, hopefully with a less tax fraud. That was quite a shock. But yeah, unless Liverpool are about to announce a huge signing and they need all the funds they can get, even though the TV money is still there, we barely spent any of it. The TV money goes on top of what Jurgen Klopp would have had anyway. Because he spent feckle in January. But I just can't figure it out. Yeah, we signed Mane, but that doesn't mean anything. It just means Ibe isn't ready for first team football. Well, so send him on loan. I mean, Callum McManaman. Or do what I'm doing, and is play him in the cups. Every single cup game. Grant. And the tackler has been very successful there. He's got possession. You know, we're not going to have, Champions League or Europa League this season, so there would be less games that he could compete in. Whereas for Bournemouth, he'll probably play every single game, especially with, cuz I don't think they made their loan of Manuel Iturbe permanent. At least I don't think they did. Maybe they did. I haven't heard anything about that. But I can't put my finger on it. Why this is being allowed to happen? And on top of that, I'm hearing that Man United might be close to signing Pogba for 100 million. And I'm like, are you fucking serious? Am I in hell or something?
these rumours, but...
How is it? Man United, no Champions League football, can spend 100 million on one of the best players in the world. Liverpool, oh, no Champions League football. Oh, we're selling one of our best young players. Where's the fucking logic? Where is the logic?
And it's now with Liverpool. Into the attacking third. Good skip. This might be it. That is a fantastic...
I mean, it just... It makes no sense. I'm almost praying for Jordan and I to come out and say... No, I'm not going to Bournemouth. I'm staying at Liverpool to fight for my place. But I just get the feeling that he'll go because, you know, it's the opportunity to play first team football on a regular basis.
James Morrison.
Is in when you're young.
But there's a lot more of it still
in talent like Ibe is. That's something you just have. You can't turn down. So, pretty much every team is trying to improve their squad. Especially the teams that finished above us. The teams that finished above us, they're all improving. Our best signing, our biggest signing, Mane. No offense to Mane, but really? Aren't we going to break the bank? Where's our amazing signing? Why don't we bring in a world-class player? I don't care if he wants to... If we have to drag him kicking and screaming. Whether Germany go out tonight or they win the whole fucking thing. Make a bid for Mario Götze or Marco Reus or someone. Someone, make it worth... Let's get excited about a Liverpool transfer and not shake our head and wonder or what happened. Where's the desire? Where's the passion? Where's the intent to sign great players? I mean, for fuck's sake. I know. Oh, Liverpool. Oh, I haven't won a trophy in 4 years. So what? Man United haven't won anything in a few years either. Except one FA Cup. They've won trophy in a few years. Liverpool have won trophy in a few years. United have a few more leagues. So what? We have more Champions Leagues.
Throw him to Liverpool.
Not having Champions League football is no longer an issue.
Real good contest between these two as they jostle for.
When Henrik Mkhitaryan would rather play Europa League football for loads of money at Manchester United instead of playing Champions League football for Dortmund and getting to at least a quarter final, well, depending on how their draw is. And probably going out in the fucking group stage with Man United. I don't care if they have Ibrahim Pogba. That doesn't mean shit. Because, did you see Ibra at the Euros? He was pathetic. But is good at Juventus because he has good players around him. United do not have those kind of players anymore.
Forward to joining you in the country for
Victor Wanyama.
Their best rated midfielder can't take a sudden penalty to save his life.
And they've got this equalizer.
It's an absolute disgrace. I mean, if we sell Che Ojo, I don't know what I'll do. Because that will be that quite simply would be the point of no return. I'll be like, what's the freaking point? What is the freaking point? Because If we're going to allow all the other teams around us get better while we don't improve, and I'm not bashing our signings. If Jurgen Klopp wants them, he fully trusts that he'll get the best out of Joel Matip, Hip, and Lloris Karius, and Sadio Mane, and whoever else he might sign. But if we're going to let everyone else just buy their way past us, we'll find ourselves slipping down the table and not getting anywhere near fourth. That's the world we live in. You have to spend money to improve, and right now, I can't see us finishing in the top four. Unless our team all has a superb, fantastic, brilliant season. Like Leicester good. That's how good a season we will need. Or everyone else will just have to be utter shit, and that's not going to happen again. We can't rely on that happening again. You've asked me, it's a silly, stupid decision.
A booking, out comes the yellow card. Well, he reached straight for his pocket. He didn't really think about it, but I think that's the good call. All trying to sneak forward. The referee's taken the right steps.
Ref, can I take my free kick without you interrupting? I have 10 minutes to score a goal. Well, I don't need you interrupting.
Well, he went for goal, and that was optimistic, but he was quite close.
Now, self put more curve on it.
He would have got to it, but decent strike.
Win the header, win the header, win the header. I'm not going to extra time.
Is this going to end level, or are we going to get a winner in the closing minutes? It'd be tough for any team to lose this, but that was a close one, I think.
I had the ball, let me play on, you freaking idiots!
Only 5 minutes of the 90 still to go, and the scores are still level. And here's the cross. Comes out with a punch to clear the danger.
John to the top. Origi Ojo! Yes!
Should be enough to give them victory.
I was expecting that to be Origi. It doesn't really matter who it is. Shay Ojo, you freaking legend. That's exactly what I wanted.
And Liverpool have got the goal. Well, talk about luck. The keeper makes a good save, but straight into the path of the attacker.
I think Ojo is going to go down as assisting himself, because I think it hit him before he headered it in. That's four goals in the one cup.
But this very, very late goal has changed that.
I remember scoring four goals with him in the Cavill One Cup. Maybe he scored a few with Ipswich. That's what I'm going to assume happened. Because I don't remember scoring four goals with him. Oh, Dragowski, you brilliant man. Keep it in, Ibe.
Good take by the goalkeeper, but no pressure on him. Is their trophy?
Yes.
They have won the English League Cup.
Ojo can't believe it. Yeah, you scored the winning goal. Oh. We'll talk about pulling one out of your fucking ass. This is why you don't sell your good young players. You keep them. Mold them into amazing players. If they turn an asshole, then you sell them and you replace them and they become shit. Like, my grabbing an utter shit Sterling. Absolutely, Gareth. Is that the first? That might be the first time he's asked me in this whole career mode. I might be wrong about that, but I think that's like the first time he's asked me in the whole career mode, which is weird. 400, huh? I'll go 415. He has 3 years, so I don't really need to try and lure him into get him to sign any extended deal. 1 year should be fine. Go with the black jersey because Arsenal have a bit of white in their jerseys. We're not clashing it in any way whatsoever. Plus, I rather like the black jersey. Looks cool. Oops. Screw this. Let's just get on with the match.
Top defending this season.
Let's go.
To hand it to Liverpool.
No, I think the home side will have to produce something special to break through this defence.
No, straight away.
Two changes. Petacek starts in goal. Monreal
gives it to Neymar. Oh, and Cech saves it. You fucking asshole. He saved it with his muscles.
A beast fist away by the keeper.
There we go. Neymar scores this time. Him inside 5 minutes. The deadlock is broken.
Neymar, and he knew exactly where the keeper was there. He knew he didn't have to hit it particularly hard, you know.
Neymar turns, shoots, boom.
Here's the goal again.
Simple, really. He was lucky Laporte got out of the way when he did. There's a French ass would have gotten in the way.
Very good intercepting play there to get his positional situation right and win the ball without too much effort.
Neymar. That wasn't exactly great. Rodriguez makes it great though. Oh, as he puts in the loose ball and makes it 2-0 almost instantly.
The goal from a player who's been defending.
Neymar, first cross. Coutinho went for the spectacular and completely he missed the loose ball, falls to Rodrigo, he hits it, it takes the deflection off of Verratti, I think? It took a deflection off of? It's Rodriguez's goal in any event, but I'm not sure who it took a deflection off of, but it did take a deflection. And that's his second goal of the season.
Defenders
don't normally score goals, but when they do, they pull it out. And 22 is Verratti, so I was correct. So if it was the Arsenal player who blocked it, although if it were a Liverpool player, it would have gone down as his goal instead of Rodriguez's. So it must have hit Verratti, because I definitely saw it take a deflection off someone. He was the one who was right there.
And it's now with Liverpool.
Coutinho wins the ball. Pull back. Neymar. Doesn't go for the chip. Why didn't he go for the chip? I don't care if you're offside. Hey, that doesn't mean you don't go for the chip. The obvious chip. As it were. Neymar. Gets a second opportunity. Check saves it. Why did he hit it straight at him? To the man's.
Marco Reus. And the cross comes in now. Ronaldo
3-0.
What a goal!
Oh, thank you very much, Arsenal. I'll take those easy 3 points. Arsenal are in third place. What is this? I'm brushing them aside like they're bottom of the table.
Let's have another peek at that goal.
It's almost like real life. If we're the teams that are higher in the table, we'll play worse against Liverpool from most of the time. And the teams that are lower in the table play amazing. I mean, I've gotten a better match out of Middlesbrough a few episodes ago. And Middlesbrough, at the time, I think they still are bottom of the table.
Nacho Monreal.
Arsenal, like I said, at last time I checked, were third in the table. They should be giving me a match. It's instead of Middlesbrough. I should be sweeping aside teams like Middlesbrough and barely beating teams like Arsenal. Legendary just can't make up its mind sometimes. Who's good and who's shit? Because I mean, right now I'm ripping this Arsenal team into shreds. Look at this, Nathaniel Clyne, he gets through. If not for Cech, it'd be about 4-5-0 already. Timmans, oh! The rebound almost went in off of Cech. Which would have been a tasty dish of irony and karma, all wrapped into one.
Nacho Monreal.
Tasty, tasty meal. For the Czech Republic goalkeeper.
I'm gonna trust his goalkeeper's footwork here.
Pass it! Don't! Now is not a good time to pass it to practice. It's doing whatever the fuck that was.
Well, they look promising there in that wide area, but the defender's done well. 3 minutes, that's what's...
Oops. It's going to be a yellow card for America Forte. Yeah, I knew it straight away.
A yellow card.
Yeah, and that player's just got to be careful now. Fair portion of
my bad. The free kick leads to nothing, and that's probably going to be the end of the first half.
You do get your rewards, but not today for Arsenal.
Yeah, they do say possession, 9/10 of the law.
Oh, wait, Coutinho, it's through, 4-0. Oh, how did he miss? In fact, he ended up in the goal instead of the ball.
Superb from one side, and rather lackluster from the other. Big goal for them.
Ooh. Look at that. That's domination. And Arsenal haven't even had a chance.
For a team with so much of an advantage.
I had a tougher game against West Brom, who 45 minutes, but we'll I'm not sure where they are in the table, but I'm pretty sure it's not second.
Good challenge between the two of them there.
Or anywhere in the top five. At least I can't confirm or deny that. They might be, for all I know.
Verratti.
Well, they're definitely not second. That's Man United. But, they might be third after this because Arsenal are rubbish.
EA Sports continues its coverage from the Barclays Premier League. The fixture, Arsenal, they'll be hosting Everton.
Yeah, I've had a lot of supporters get excited about it, and I am as well.
I wonder if that counts as a shot for Arsenal. Be interesting to see the after game stats, see if that
Marco Reus.
Little thing with the goalkeeper was a shot. Or was deemed a shot. Well, they might get a shot away here anyway if they actually shoot, and they didn't. Brilliant, pointless play as always, Arsenal.
This could be it.
Oh, Wolfe, thank you very much. Oh, I didn't. Why didn't he shoot it? I pressed the circle button and he doesn't do. Who's him? What command?
Sunderland in the next match in the Barclays Premier League, and I don't think they'll find too many obstacles in the way.
Some activity down on the Arsenal.
Great tackle by Rodriguez.
Into the tackle, and the result is going to be a throw.
It's like Arsenal are making a substitution. They're making a double substitution.
But doing the basics of fullback play, defending, stopping crosses coming in, trying to get forward as well to help the attack. None of that's happened today.
No, he seemed in a different.
Oh, there we go. Now they've definitely had at least one shot. Foul.
It will be
there. Ring clears after the obvious foul was ignored.
The change now for Arsenal.
I think Verratti just went off. He did for Jack Wheelchair.
Able to make a good interception.
It's weird looking at Aaron Ramsey and not seeing his new hair. That'll be interesting to look out for next FIFA, as Marco Reus makes it 4-0.
The Gotham boys. Well, he's just feathered that into the right-hand side.
Jack is like, why are they scoring so many goals against me?
One team really on their game today. The other very off-colour.
And shoots! Oh, it's 5-0. Neymar makes it 5.
A goal from Neymar. And the way he stopped that. Wow.
Back to back. Instantaneous.
I don't think we expected this.
Up in this bitch.
Affair, but look at the scoreline. Mathieu Debuchy. Laurent Koscielny trying to stretch the opposition using the wider areas here. Nathaniel Klein.
Klein takes the ball. Timmans. He's gonna outplay.
Not a good challenge by the defender.
He's Martinez and Socrates, right? Yes, he is, and he's gonna score. Or to make it 6-0. Oh.
There's another one for them.
Well, it's certainly gonna help the goal difference. It might be important.
Well, he was fouled right there, and you can see the linesman even acknowledged it. But that's what happens when you let play go on.
Realistically, the of the game.
It will happen when the referee, he and
so far ahead.
His assistants actually acknowledge the rule book.
Nathaniel Klein.
Funny how that works.
You can see what he was trying to do, but the pass wasn't on. It was a
funny and crazy.
Turned out. Olivier Giroud. That's a great interception. Santi Cazorla.
Chamra.
Ricardo
running out for a throw.
We can tell he knows the game.
I'm quite lucky because that would have been a second yellow card.
The ball.
Heard. That wasn't an American report day though. That was Rodriguez, I think, committed the foul on
Ricardo Rodriguez.
Chamberlain. Neymar, he's on a hat trick. He's worked his way into the box and Cech denies him.
Corner.
The goal kick will. Oh, it's a corner. Never mind. Why did I think it was a goal kick? Ronaldo! Oh! Pretty much off the line.
And they've cut the pass out there. And maybe that will ease the pressure.
There's the full time whistle. Oh. Another 3 points in the bag. Like, Arsenal were just utterly shit. It's throughout the whole game, they had one shot throughout the whole game. how they are third in the table, I don't know. It doesn't seem logical. But then again, what do I know about logical? I'm just a smarky fan. So yeah, next episode I will take on both Sunderland and Newcastle. Also a doubleheader from the Black Cats and the Toon. Or the Geordies, or whatever they want prefer to be called. After the next episode, I will have played 30 league games. Fancy. So yeah. Until then, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button if you did. And hit the subscribe button if you're new to the channel so you don't miss any future videos from yours truly. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.